Look, good shit on those contracts you've been working on. But listen, I got some other work. A certain kind of work that need a certain kind of person, you know what I mean? Big ticket type shit. I don't want to say too much on myself, so I'll be in touch with you on a payphone. Keep your ears open. So when was the last time you used a payphone? Cause believe me, there's some things you don't want the FIB to hear. You know, things like contract killings, stock manipulation. You feel me? Cause see, I knew the dude that used to run the hits in this town, and he knew something most of the hatchet guys out there don't. The money only starts flowing when the stock market gets involved. Now, I got my share of high net worth individuals in my contact these days. And since we got our own partnership up and running, a few of them start hitting me up with propositions that be making me think, shit, I need to get back in the game. With me running the plays and you working the fields, man. So look, here's the deal. We take out some assholes who fucking deserve it anyway, which fixes the market in our own client's favor, and then they send us some serious pay dirt. You got me? All you gotta do is pick up the phone. I'll give you the mark, and then I'll text you some details from the burner. You can do it however you want, but the clients pay extra if you do it just right. Sounds good? Hey, what's up? Just calling to say well done with that recent business venture of ours. Shit, you should have the money by now. And I just wanted to say the client was very pleased with your attention to detail. But look, keep your ears to the ground for more work, all right? Or hit me up anytime and I'll see what I got for you. Hey, I will give you this target's name, but I know you haven't heard it before. He ain't even famous yet. But shit, he about to be. Some sick degenerate trust fund kid who fucks up people's lives for fun. He spiked girl drinks, done hit and runs, assaults, man, you name it. And then he paid his way out of all that shit. And now he wanna do some reputation management so he can buy his way into being the next big pop star. He got a label and a song that's all paid and bought for. He got an ass face and social media campaign ready to fucking go. He's all set to scoop a number one single when it drops next week. Now I know what you're thinking. Another manufactured pop star. So what? Who cares? Well, our client works at the record label, and he got some nice intel. The label sunk everything they got into this little son of a bitch. And if he has an accident, not only will the world be a better place, but the label fixing to go bankrupt. And our client just bet against them big. So look, we make the stock crash, our clients get some zeros added onto their bank account, and we get a slice of the motherfucking pie. Now let's go put this little evil motherfucker in the wrong kind of headlines.
Love you.
You ever heard of the show called Closet CEO? Where some asshole billionaire pretends to be one of his broke-ass employees for a day or two. Well, keep thinking about that, and then think about the CEO of Gold Coast Development. This dude is a world-class asshole, union-busting, poor working conditions, corruption, intimidation, man, you name it. And check this out. Now he about to throw in some overalls and play nice for the workers on his site for the cameras. Now, full disclosure, I did some work a while ago that gave this asshole market value a boost, but that was before I heard what a piece of shit this fucker really is. So when a client came to me with a proposal to make some bills off liquidating his ass, man, I said, hell yeah. Our client gonna short the fuck out the Gold Coast Development stock, then we gonna ice this fool while he's playing construction worker for this dumbass show. The stock tank, our client get rich, we get paid. And if we make it look like he died because of some unsafe conditions on his site, makes it even better. Hey, look, today's target is a cautionary tale, homie. The target is one of the founding members of that phone company, Bittersweet. Man, back in the day, he lived a whole Vinewood tech pioneer life. Private jets, kale smoothies, cocaine for breakfast. Man, you know all that crazy shit. Then everyone started buying iPhone phones instead. And he went off the rail real fucking fast. Got into all sorts of nasty shit. And I mean nasty shit. And the company fucking tanked. But now they got a chance of a new relaunch to turn it all around. But here's where we come in. His co-founder's still clean as they come. But he can't do shit while this degenerate fuck has the reins. So we gonna arrange for him to have a little accident. The co-founder takes over, and then the stock prices pick up. Which means our client's gonna make big fucking bank. And we get paid. We got the target at the motel with a nasty ass prostitute right now. Go put his ass out of his misery.
What brings you in today? Better than when she came in, that's for sure.
supposed to come in. I'm good, Miss G. Staying positive, looking for a job, trying not to kill myself.
Shit.
Man, this should be a wholesome-ass day of work. The target is some backwards-ass judge that changes the sentences for anyone who offers her a fur coat or a stack of fucking cash. She put a lot of innocent people in jail. Some fucking people I even know. And tomorrow, she's ruling on a big fraud case against one of our partners at Lombank. The whole world knows he's guilty as fuck, so a bunch of our clients are out there betting against Lombank's stock. Only I just got wind the lady judge been paid to throw the fucking case out. And if the defendant walk and the stock don't tank, our clients stand to lose a lot of fucking money. So I say we bring some karma to this evil-ass bitch. Take her out, and our clients will give us a nice kickback when justice takes its course. So look, she's at the golf course right now, playing around to celebrate in advance. Your outfit should still be at the clubhouse. I suggest you go pay her ass a visit.
Thank you.
Don't make me report you!
Oh, I still get my fair share of male attention, let me tell you.
Your girl got thumbs all over her hand.
Whatever. So what? We hook after our own. Bye. Scissor sisters locked together.
Cotton candy.
Thank you.
You fucking prick!
Fucking Franco just got hit!
Hey, this target is one of the most successful tech entrepreneurs in the world, but you ain't never even heard of his damn name. Now this motherfucker, he keeps a low profile, even though he designed half the fucking apps on your damn phone. You know, social media, video sharing, photo sharing, messaging, you name it, this dude wrote it. And get this, as of tomorrow, he's gonna push what looks like a routine security update. But really, it's a back door so he can sell all your data to the highest bidder. Fucking son of a bitch. He don't care how many people he bankrupts, long as his fucking ass is sitting at the beach in the Caymans next to 10 figures in his fucking bank account. He got every crooked investor with an internet connection looking to buy his stocks once the update hits. But check this out. One of our investors had an even better idea, and he came to me with it. He's gonna bet against the stock. Then we take this bitch down. Our client cashes out, and we make bank. We just got intel that the target is fucked up right now at some charity event. And fired his driver for the fucking 10th time. And he just ordered a cab. But I got Imani to cancel that motherfucker. Dude should be right outside.
Okay, drive careful! Hello.
All right, look, so the internet is a huge and terrible place that I still don't understand. But the bottom line is, we got some trolls out there banding together to fuck with the stock prices. I seen some creepy-ass nasty stuff on their message boards, and they got the whole fucking army out there dumping and pumping their shit wherever they like. They've been rigging prices all over the market, cashing out and fucking everybody else in the process, including a bunch of our clients. And right now, they targeting a stock pick that we all should be worried about. It's a tall ask, but man, I need you to get rid of as many other ringleaders of these basement-dwelling crooks as you can before they crash the fucking stock. And look, if you do right, a lot of very rich people gonna be very grateful to us, and we gonna get paid.
Thank you.
so you know Merryweather, right? Shit, of course you do. Anyone who cut their teeth in this town spent a whole lot of time fucking with Merryweather. Ain't no coincidence that stock price is at an all-time low. So look, we got a client who's gonna pay us to do him a favor for once. But hear me out on this one. There's a bunch of creepy-ass drug dealers making headlines right now, selling nasty shit to anyone and everyone. The whole city wants them dealt with. Hey, so look, you gonna make them disappear. Make it look professional and shit. And I'ma get on Snapmatic, start spamming, posting, saying, I saw Merryweather take these fools down, and the cops couldn't. And boom, Merryweather goes viral with some good publicity. Our client make a bunch of money because she just bought a lot of their stock, and then we get paid. Everybody's a fucking winner, right? I normally don't fuck with rats. But in this case, some of the homies that used to work for Coil is sitting on all this top secret evidence about how the company's car batteries are actually poisoning the whole fucking earth. After all the green energy marketing and shit, this is unfucking believable, right? Well, no surprise, but the Coil CEO is panicking. He actually hired some goons to take out our guy before he even goes public. Man, these motherfucking batteries are gonna kill us all. And he's worrying about the fucking stock tanking. Well, look, our client is an insider who cares passionately about the truth and the fucking environment. And more to the point, he just bet big against Coil to cash in when the snitch goes public. So look, we take out the hitman, make sure the rat gets his spotlight. Our client make bank, shit, so do we.